Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. It's your weekly portion of Russian accent, travel and tech videos. So as I said in the previous video, I was actually thinking about how to combine my travel and tech videos, and so far I'm just like trying my best, because it's really hard to come up with a scenario like what exactly I want to shoot in the specific video about travel. Because if we talk about tech, it's easy to just like, I don't know, come up a specific topic and just like shoot a video. But if, in terms of travel, you actually need to plan out the whole thing, and sometimes it's really hard because you don't know exactly what to expect and all that. So yeah, I'm just trying my best to actually come up with good travel ideas, but so far I'm just combining those together and just inserting this one in the tech video. So let's see how it works out. Talking about tech videos, I was thinking really hard with like what video should I come up with. I came up with the Windows Millennium on M1 Mac video, so let's see how it works out. We're gonna use the UTM to emulate this, because I was thinking about Parallels, but Parallels just recently, they decided to just basically end the trial, and the guys, there's no more trial on M1 Macs. You need to actually purchase the license, which I think it's alright. I understand it's a commercial product, but guys, I wish there were like a little bit more time for us to just to try it out. As of now, I'm just like, I'm not gonna pay like the amount of money they asking for. I'm not gonna pay that. I'm actually waiting for the free solutions for now, and if there's none, I'm gonna actually purchase the Parallels. I don't know guys, how about you, but I'm just gonna use the UTM, which is a free solution, and let's see how it works. Alright, so let's actually create the virtual machine. So I'm gonna press the button, virtual machine. We're gonna actually name it Windows Me. And why Windows Millennium? Well, because Windows 98, I mean, even the second edition, it's, of course, it's really, really old, like it's Windows Millennium, but I found there are like much more troubles with Windows 98 than Windows Millennium, so that's why we're gonna try this one. And to be honest, there's like not much difference actually. You can always customize it and get back to the Windows 98 kind of stuff, system files and all that, and get MS-DOS, for example, real mode back on Windows Millennium. So how about that? Windows Millennium style operating system. Alright, so here, memory. I would say 512 is okay. It's, I mean, it's a lot actually for this system. So how about we pick, so it should be x86, because there's no 64-bit, there's nothing. System standard PC, no, 2009, no, it's like really, really modern. Let's pick something like this from 1996. Let me think which one to pick. How about we're just gonna pick this one, default one. System standard PC default, because this one I'm not sure, it says alias of PC. This one, okay, pretty much probably the same thing. All right, so let's pick this one. And memory, honestly, let's just pick 256, guys. This is like good enough. Show advanced settings, CPU. Probably the default one, I'm gonna pick the right CPU for this system, so let's see how it works. Of course, there's no multi-core and all that, so let's. Oh, okay, guys, it crashed. Alright, so there's a difference between the free product and the commercial product. Yeah, as you can see. Alright, let's try it once again. UTM, create new virtual machine, system. Okay, guys, let's see what should we do this time. Okay, this time 256, and again, let's try to pick the one from 1996. Oh, deprecated. What's it, like, what exactly does it mean? Deprecated in what sense? Deprecated in this particular product, or deprecated like, I know that's deprecated like anywhere from, anything from 1996 is deprecated those days, but maybe let's pick this one. Let's see if it works out or not. Okay, this time it didn't crash. Will it crash if I just gonna switch it back here? Just once again, like this. No, it doesn't seem to crash. Anyway, I think let's start with this one, 5.1, I don't know. Drives, let's create a new drive. Of course, there should be IDE, size 10GB, that's good enough. Removable, no, should be IDE. Create, sounds nice. Display, full graphics and all that. Network, you know guys, let's pretty much just pick whatever is there. I guess it should work. So the Sound Blaster, I'm actually gonna change from the AC97 to Sound Blaster 16, because that's what I was using back in those days. I think this one is actually what we should try here. Should work, I guess. Standard PC, alright guys, I'm not really sure, but the year is 1996, so I guess it should work. Okay, legacy PC 2 mouse, definitely. This is what we should pick. Operating system, Windows Millennium system. Where is the, how can we, okay, there should be a way to select a CD drive. Where's the CD drive? SCSI SD card. Okay, let's try SD card. Okay, image type, CD image, alright. That sounds good. Alright, it actually should ask for the specific CD image that we have. So let's see how it plays out. So this is not removable. Both should be IDE. IDE. Alright, so let's try this. Let's see if it even starts. UTM. Alright, open source network boot, but it should actually ask to... Okay. Alright, so I need to pick the CD drive, and here is like this one. Now I need to reboot. Okay, restart, boot from CD-ROM. Let's see, guys, if it works. Oh yeah, it works. It seems to be loading something. Some coffee never hurts. Oh, I forgot to say, guys, this might be a Russian version, actually. Alright, is it actually booting? That's nice, it actually works. Alright, welcome to installation software program. Enter. Alright, so we just gonna... There are two options, basically. Just quit the setup and prepare this for installation. Alright. Alright, it says your hard drive is more than 512 MB. Would you like to enable support of the hard drives? Yeah, for sure. Why should I select, like, why should I actually pick the other option? I don't know. All right. Right now, the computer will be restarted. Please insert the image in the floppy drive. Nice, nice. Floppy drive for sure. Should I pick this? No, I guess not. Okay. No, no, no. So I'm gonna pick this one. Start from the CD-ROM. I just don't get it, why it just takes so much time to initialize the CD-ROM. And I remember back in those days, it was a really big deal. The CD-ROM initialization took so much time, guys. I don't know, sometimes it took like up to a minute. I mean, it was crazy. Let's see how it works. Let's see. It's been a while since I was using Windows Millennium. I actually have it installed on a ThinkPad, an old ThinkPad, and I mean, it's pretty nice, but sometimes it's nice to have it somewhere like portable, somewhere like on my M1 Mac. Let's see. I mean, I'm wondering if the sound will work, and I'm wondering if the internet will work eventually, because probably we just need to play around with the interfaces and see how it works. Alright, it says formatting disk C. Let's see. And so far, so good. So far, the installation proceeds. I have a good feeling about this all. So right now we need to check the whole system. Right now it says it needs to check the system. Oh, I remember that. I just need to start scan disk and actually scan the whole drive. But guys, it was just formatted like a few seconds ago, and now it needs to check it. This sounds crazy. I don't know. This sounds so insane. There's actually a way to skip it, but let's go ahead and see how it works. And it actually checks the surface. There's like one of the checks, one of the last checks, which I really, really didn't like. It was the last one that was actually checking the surface of the hard drive. It was like took a while, actually. All right, guys, it actually starting up. Let's say installing Windows Millennium Edition. See? It's possible. I think it's really cool to actually be able to run your old games. Particularly, I'm thinking about Red Alert 2. This one was like one of my favorite games. I loved it. Alright, so installation in Russian. The cursor just goes crazy. It goes nuts. I don't know how to... Guys, I don't know how to manage the cursor. Alright, I don't like that part, but maybe we can just get by with the keyboard. Let's see. The shortcuts and all that. Some problem, it just crashed. Okay, you need to restart it, it says. Okay, boot from CD-ROM. Okay, it didn't crash this time. Come on, like what doesn't work? Okay, I need to just to focus on this one. Alright, next. Alright, install here. I'm gonna say yes. Okay, I'm just not gonna even like try to touch the mouse. I'm just gonna use the keyboard to basically install stuff like that. I'm just gonna use the tab to basically navigate this whole thing. Maybe after I install the stuff, maybe at some point it's actually gonna work just fine. So let's see. Guys, what I've noticed is that basically I feel like it should be installed much, much faster. It's been like more than half an hour and it just still keeps installing all that. And of course my system is really, really fast. I don't know why it takes so long. Alright guys, so after it all installed, after we have everything ready, the only thing I would suggest to do is basically go to edit. And how about we're just gonna move the CD drive here, like this, and then we're gonna save it like that. Because we want it to boot by default from the hard drive, not from the CD. And then let's actually start. Alright. booting from hard drive. Let's see. Alright, and this is how it works. There's no sound. The video driver is also quite bad. I need to install some kind of universal driver and see how it works. But, okay, and the mouse just keeps disappearing. I need to press that button to keep it in the loop. And let's see. Alright, so Windows version. And of course, I need to switch the keyboard to English like that. Windows version, WinVer. Alright, so it says Windows Millennium 2000 copyright. That makes sense, but guys, I just love those icons. Those icons actually were used like in Windows 2000 kind of environment, so I love those icons. But it seems to be working kind of slow for this computer. I mean, it should fly, but it's not. It's just like working kind of slowish. So let's open Internet Explorer. Alright, I already know that it doesn't work, so if I type anything here like this, it will not work. So there's no internet, guys. I need to figure out which adapter I need to use here. But I just love this like spinning around the Internet Explorer logo. I was always actually curious about this one. Like I always loved it as a child. I remember you just open the website and this one just like spins around like that. So it was cool. Also this messenger icon right here, Microsoft Messenger, guys. Oh my gosh, so many memories about this one. It was really, really good. Back in those days. And then, by the way, the games, like there's a bunch of games installed right here, of course, like the Solitaire, all this kind of stuff, classic kind of stuff here, because here, disk defragmentation, disk cleanup, disk checkup, whatever, all this stuff, even the Windows Movie Maker, like the first, one of the first versions right here. I mean, I actually did some movies using this one. Oh my gosh, so many memories. But the main feature here, the main feature was like the MS-DOS session actually in the Windows 98 and Windows Millennium, because guys, it was so cool. And of course, if you ping something, it will not work. Yes, it says unknown host. But for the games, for all this good stuff from 90s, like this one was really cool. And you can still use it for old games. Of course, you can use also the Dustbox, which I think is a better option, but you can also try that one. So Windows Millennium works. It actually does work on M1 Mac without much problems. But guys, you need to be aware that it's kind of slow, sluggish for some reason. Maybe because I need to install the video driver and maybe I just need to figure out some stuff here. Maybe it's gonna work just fine, but it's a good start. I got the mouse operating just fine. Maybe I need to play around with the settings of the virtual machine to pick better hardware. You see like that, because you saw there's so many revisions you can pick the CPU type and all that. So maybe it's gonna work just fine. I don't know. Let's see. It's pretty fun stuff. All right, guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. There'll be more videos, travel and tech stuff, and see you soon. All right. Bye.